In this video, we're going to go over one of the unique features of the CONVERT-2, the USB Uplink. If you're not already familiar with the basics of the CONVERT-2, click here to watch an overview video. In the input section of the CONVERT-2, you'll notice this little LED above AES SPDIF2. It says 2 USB. If I hold down AES SPDIF2, this LED will start to blink, letting me know that this feature is engaged. Let's take a look at a diagram to see exactly what's going on here. Any digital signal that is plugged into the AES SPDIF2 will now also be routed back to your DAW via the USB cable connected to the CONVERT-2. Let's use a real-life example. Here I'm mastering a track using analog outboard gear, and I want to get it back into my DAW for capture, but I also want to add some plugins to it, and I want to be able to monitor those as well. I have an AD converter here, but that doesn't actually get my signal back into the DAW. It just converts it from an analog signal to an AES digital signal. That's where the CONVERT-2 comes in. If I plug the digital output of my AD into the AES SPDIF2 input of the CONVERT-2, I can send the signal right back to my DAW without having to plug any extra devices into my computer. I can also still monitor this source just as I normally would. One thing that's important to mention here is that when you're in uplink mode, AES SPDIF1 and ADAT are both disabled. This allows everything to lock to the same clock via USB. You still get to choose which clock to follow, and I highly recommend using the CONVERT-2 as the master. Aside from the convenience, there are a couple important advantages to using uplink. The first is that I can monitor everything through the same reference DA, and that allows me to make accurate comparisons. That's critical in mixing and mastering scenarios. The second is I can now compare the sound before it goes into the DAW to the sound after it comes back from the DAW so that I can hear if my plugins are actually doing what I want them to. A bonus that's exclusive to the CONVERT-2 is that using the meter, I can see the peak and RMS levels before going to the plugins and after the plugins. That allows me to compare the two. So if I select AES SPDIF2, I can hear my master before it goes back into the DAW. This means I'm hearing it before any of the plugins. In Pro Tools, I have my final print track going out via USB to the CONVERT-2. So when I hit USB, I'm hearing my final master, including all of the plugins that I added in the DAW. And this is the absolute last step in the signal chain. If I toggle between these two inputs, I can compare the sound, and I can also see what's happening on my meters. Now that I have those tools at my disposal, I can go ahead and polish off my mix or my master. That sums up the CONVERT-2 USB uplink. If you have any questions or need any help with your dangerous gear, please feel free to email us at info@dangerousmusic.com.